The political party of presidential aspirant Ferdinand Marcos Jr. wants poll commissioner Rowena Guanzon disbarred and her retirement benefits forfeited. Partido Federal ng Pilipinas General Counsel Attorney George Briones slams Guanzon for what he described as the illegal leaking of her decision on the Marcos disqualification cases. He points out no decision has been promulgated yet by the COMELEC First Division. Briones also called out Guanzon for implying that a politician intervened in the case, saying it's double hearsay. He calls on the COMELEC en banc to conduct an administrative investigation on Guanzon. But Guanzon is unfazed. She challenges Briones to engage her in a debate on TV. Guanzon maintains she's standing for transparency, the truth, and timely government service for all Filipinos. Outgoing Election Commissioner Rowena Guanzon believes or reveals she voted to disqualify the late dictator's son, Ferdinand Marcos Jr., from the presidential race. Guanzon adds the much-anticipated decision of the poll body's first division on the case is under pressure from external forces. Ina Reformina reports.
The COMELEC First Division has yet to vote on three consolidated petitions seeking to disqualify presidential contender Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. But the division's presiding officer and most senior commissioner, Rowena Guanzon, is already making public her vote in favor of the petitioners.
So your vote was to disqualify Bongbong Marcos, tama po ko?
Yes, kasi who is has the duty to write the resolution, 16 days na, hindi pa niya nilalabas eh. Eh, may agreement naman kami na January 17 nilabas. So, January 17, hindi niya nilabas. Ako, nilabas ko yung voto ko in a separate opinion. The separate opinion is a separate written vote of any commissioner, separate from the resolution.
The petitions were separately filed by martial law survivors led by Bonifacio Ilagan, Akbayan Citizens Action Party, and Abubakar Mangelen, Commissioner of the National Commission on Muslim Filipinos and former chairman of Marcos's political party, Partido Federal ng Pilipinas. Guanzon, who retires on Wednesday, February 2, believes Marcos has been sentenced to a crime involving moral turpitude, which is one of the grounds for disqualification under the Omnibus Election Code.
The issue is Section 12 of the Omnibus Election Code. And the issue is their moral turpitude. When he did not file his income tax return for 4 years as governor of Ilocos Norte, I found that there is moral turpitude. Why? He did not only not file his income tax and pay his income tax once, but 4 times. And he was governor. He was not an ordinary citizen. Furthermore, when the court of appeals convicted him, although there was no imprisonment, there was a fine, his lawyer admitted during the hearing that they did not pay the fine in the regional trial court.
Like the upper-level courts, the COMELEC keeps confidential the identity of the ponente or commissioner in charge of a particular case, who is tasked to write the draft ruling or ponencia. But Guanzon is naming Commissioner Amy Ferrolino as the ponente in this case.
The other commissioner, Commissioner Casquejo, already tried to reach also Commissioner Ferrolino, but she was not answering.
The poll body earlier announced one of the ponente's lawyers contracted COVID-19 to explain why the January 17 target release of the resolution was not met. Guanzon suspects an unseen hand interfering in the case. The commissioner says she cannot determine the fate of her vote, whether it will be counted or set aside, if the division still does not set the voting prior to her retirement.
Ibig sabihin may naging political interference. Kasi obvious ba, hindi naman siya sumasagot na ng telepono niya, ayaw niya talaga sumagot. So, bakit ba ayaw sumagot? Eh, talo o panalo si Bongbong Marcos dito, mag-motion for reconsideration din naman sila eh. Tumungin niya na lang si Secretary Salpanelo as spokesman eh. Anong comment niya dito?
Commissioner Ferrolino refuses to comment for now, citing the sub judice rule. Guanzon, who is applying for deputy ombudsman for the Visayas, stresses it is in the best interest of all parties for this case to be expeditiously resolved so that it can be elevated to the Supreme Court.
It's going to have consequences. What if they are DQ'd in the Supreme Court after the election? What's going to happen? He cannot assume office.
Marcos's name is included in the ballot, which has already started printing since the 20th. Since this consolidated case and four other separate cases against his Malacañang bid have not yet attained finality. Ina Reformina, ABS-CBN News.
One of the petitioners seeking to stop Marcos's presidential bid, alarmed over alleged interference in the poll body's resolution on the disqualification cases. Akbayan Party List asserts Kamala Commissioner Guanzuan's vote should be counted despite attempts to delay a decision until she retires.
We are with her in the call na dapat bilisan yung pagdidesisyon at pangalawa, dapat bilangin yung boto ni Commissioner Guanzuan kasi bahagi ng due process at pagrespeto sa prosesong pinagdaanan namin bilang mga petitioners tulad ng Akbayan at kahit mismo yung kapwa ni Ginoong Marcos. We appeal to not just the ponente but the other members of the second division to heed their conscience and use Commissioner Guanzuan's vote as both a motivation and a guide in deciding in favor of the truth and a fair electoral system. Siguro yung paalala lang natin sa lahat ay huwag na po tayo magpabudol kay Marcos Jr.
For Howard Calleja, a lawyer for the petitioners in one of the cases, while they salute Commissioner Guanzuan's honesty, they are saddened by her revelations. Calleja adds he would still like to trust the neutrality of the poll body, hoping it would uphold its mandate of conducting an honest and truthful elections. The campaign against the return of the Marcoses and martial law, meanwhile, wants Commissioner Guanzuan to identify those who are meddling in the case. It also calls on the other poll commissioners handling the matter to decide for truth, justice, and integrity. Just a few months ago, we spoke to former chief presidential, former chief presidential legal counsel Salvador Panelo. He denied speculations Malacañang was dipping its hand in the cases. Panelo also said the alleged interference of an influential politician is alarming, as he called on the COMELEC to resolve the cases immediately.